Button check, yeah. But no, yeah, I did okay today. I did.
Good job, man.
So I beat Afro.
I love. I hope they keep this song. I'm gonna tell them.
Are they playing?
Let me tell them real quick. Wait, this is not a hand warmer anymore.
Excuse me.
Did they go from the hand warmer into the set, or was that just the most intense?
They're definitely playing.
What the hell? But at the start, you saw they were just chilling, and then they started talking. I thought, okay, whatever.
I think there was a controller issue at first.
I think they're fine now.
And they reset, so they hand warmed a little bit.
So a fun fact about these two. Reyes told me that his neutral with Joker is way better when Arsene is not alive. It's because, and I quote, Reyes told me that once Arsene is up and he has more attack power, he wants to, quote unquote, go ham.
I want some mad.
Ray told me.
I want a mad.
However, Stocktaker is really good. He lives up to his namesake, as always. His wolf has made such considerable strides.
I mean,
it's like his main character.
He is a wolf player in this game, which is like shocking to me.
I know he rotated a bunch of characters. I remember his Wii Fit.
Yeah, Wii Fit still plays Villager a little bit as well.
Thank God he saved his jump. That was the most unfortunate way to get set by that.
Which, like, this, to me, this is like, it's crazy that he plays wolf in this game, because. Like, he despises Smash 4 Cloud, and, like, this is, like, the Cloud character.
Yeah, I could see it, yeah.
Like, this is the Cloud character.
Anime DLC boy. You're talking about Wolf, right?
Yeah.
Okay. I see that, too, honestly. Yeah. He's a very neutral-heavy character with amazing tools as soon as he gets out of
neutral. Big boy hitboxes.
Yeah, big boy hitboxes, crazy combo game. Does a ton of damage.
And then he just makes you explode. He has the falling up air combos as well.
I commend Ray for trying to make this character work. He's got a very, very nice character pool.
He does have a really solid Joker. I mean, yeah, he's pretty good.
He's got the best Joker in New York, if I do say so myself.
Yeah, probably.
Who's better than him? I can't think of anybody off the top of my head. Like, everyone's picking up Joker right now, but he's been the only one to try it this deep in a bracket, which is probably why he's the best one results-wise, because he's only trying this character to be super deep in a bracket.
Yeah, I don't, because personally, I'm of the camp that Joker is just okay, and then he gets Arsene, and then he's broken.
I think he's a tad overrated right now. People are saying he's high tier with him top 20 range. I think his frame data helps him quite a bit.
Yeah.
And the way I've seen Ray play, it seems like he's playing in that chic vein of that he's a whiff punish character. He's with a whiff punish character with a semi-lethal punish game that turns into Cloud all of a sudden.
Jokes on you, Stocktaker. You're about to die.
He's one hit away from exploding. Like one back air at the edge away.
I would take two, but yeah. He's not, because, like, Stock's not going to give him back air. Oh, Jesus.
That's not true, right? I don't think it's true. No, I think it's only if you press a button.
I don't think it is ever a kill confirm, but I feel like it's true for quite some time.
That F smash with Arsene is super powerful. I think that might be his most powerful move, F smash with Arsene.
Yeah, probably.
Joker's frame data pretty damn good, though.
Pretty solid. Pretty solid for a character with a little bit of disjoint, for sure.
I'd like to see Ray stop going for shield grabs as much and start mixing in, like, F-tilt out of shield.
Yeah, you have Nair out of shield as well.
F-tilt's probably his best option out of shield.
Well, in terms of frame data, it's kind of slow. Absolutely. But, like, I would say Nair, back air, fair depending.
What is down tilt? I'm going to look that up right now, because I have the
keep in mind, you have to do all, like, 11 shield drop frames and then do down tilt.
Speaking of 11, it's already 11 o'clock, Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
It's late, boys.
Anyway,
since we gotta get to the we gotta get to
the
forge tomorrow, and Ralphie was like, "We're gonna leave." What did he hit him with? Back
that
air?
Back air.
That was
hit
the
him.
Lowest back air. Shorty got
that
low.
That back
low,
air
low.
Hit him. I like Ray's new hairstyle, by the way. I'm a fan.
I'm digging it. I told him, he looked at my hair today and was like, "I gotta start gelling my hair." So I was like, "Okay, do it."
It's a good look.
I like it, though. His hair is already naturally, like, very well-shaped.
Very neat. Yes.
I don't know what product.
It reminds me of my hair when my hair wasn't already
disappeared. Yeah, I remember your hair. I liked your hair.
Similar to that.
Down tilt comes out frame 8. Up tilt comes out frame 8 as well. So kind of slow-ish for tilts.
Yeah.
F tilt also frame 8. Okay, I didn't realize how slow all of it is.
No, yeah. That's the thing. Out of shield, it's, like, frame, like, 20
or
whatever.
Jab out of shield, then, might be better.
Okay. In reality, you're going to be going for Nair out of shield probably most of the time, just because, or Dare, one or the other, just because of you go past those shield drop frames, obviously. So you just go straight into your jump, which is only 3 frames. If you shield drop, obviously, I think it's 11 in this game, because it was like 7 and 4 to shield drop, something like that.
Ray has been doing really well in this matchup tonight. I mean, we saw him dismantle Pong earlier.
Yeah, for sure, but, you know, Stock looked very solid game number one.
I've been told Wolf wins this matchup, though.
And then Wolf players will tell you.
I've been told. Wolf
wins no top tier matchups. Hey, have you heard that Wolf wins no top tier matchups? Wolf wins no top tier matchups.
All right, guys. We get it. Your character's awful. Miserable.
The thing is, he doesn't lose any matchups particularly either.
I don't. Yeah, that's the thing. Like, it's kind of.
I feel like that's a great thing about top tiers in this game is that they're in the they're what every Sonic player in 4 said Sonic was, where he didn't lose any matchups, but he didn't win any either. I feel like the same could apply.
That guy definitely won some matchups.
Yeah, I think so too.
Sonic was broken.
Sonic players.
I hate that guy.
Sonic players will pull the victim card, whatever. Anyway. Well,
then, yeah. In this game, they were allowed to at least a little bit.
A little bit.
Now they got to pay their dues. Like I said,
I have to commend Stocktaker's ability to play when his opponent's in the corner. He really knows how to not overextend and keep his opponent freaking out.
I think that's a kind of a villager thing. Like you.
Yeah, for sure.
Absolutely. You know the tools to put like your opponent in the corner. And while Wolf obviously doesn't have like the villager backer, the villager fair, you know, the Frank 3 Nair, Wolf has the air ability to kind of feint that, where you're still covering a whole lot of space with your big hitboxes.
Right. Palutena also has been fairly polarizing lately in the climate of Tri-State.
No one likes this character.
Maybe Rage character of the week, where the Palut players are like, hey, she's not that good. Palut players are like,
hey,
no, she's
Artisan,
not
if you're in the chat, this character's top three. Anyway,
this character is really good.
Really good.
I can't say that it's not a good character.
Mario Palu is minus two.
Anyway,
I'm a results man, and you know, if this character's winning a lot, she's good.
She has results.
A bad character doesn't just win a lot.
Yeah.
That's not how that goes. That's not how that works.
Ooh.
All right. Stocktaker just tried to go for the scholarship, but then ended up firing off one into the crowd.
And, you know, after a, excuse me?
I mean, he was already committing to the upbeat recovery, so he only really had one direction going.
And Stock is doing the classic, like, Meta Knight F Smash, where he just, I'm a dash back F Smash. Come to me now, because I have no lag.
It's such low cooldown. I'm sorry for the yawns, by the way, guys. It's been a long day.
Tired, man.
I'm very tired.
Sorry,
this music might actually be putting me to sleep, honestly.
You know what, though? It's a good song.
It's good. It slaps. I want them to keep the song. I enjoy relaxing music and deep
breaking. Why are we fighting to this? Team Galactic is on this stage, and we're playing this.
I still like this song. It's a good Pokemon song. Pokemon just slaps. But anyway, anyway you slice it.
Anyway, but Palutena took the first off after a really solid lead from Stocktaker.
Nair from Ledge. I got to try that. Oh my god, whoa. He started him up with the end of the Nair. That's insane. When you have a move that's a kill move that combos into itself at any.
It does.
Coffee.
Oh, he says, I have invincibility. You better not challenge this, myself.
The thing about Ray's playstyle is that even if he looks like he's on the back foot, he's able to keep it so even.
And 83% is a whole lot of damage. So you are now in a position. Not undoable. Wolf racks up like percent.
That one fair did 11. Fair did 11.
Nair, no jump. Tries to go for the Nair. Should have committed a little bit more.
I kind of like it because there's no reason to overcommit. Like, he's still hanging in there. The thing is...
Yeah, no, right. I get it.
Stocktaker is able to find himself getting out of the corner pretty easily. Like, he'll just dart out of there. Right? He kind of slips by Ray before Ray can really do anything about it. That was a great empty hop to beat out. I think it was the shield. Wow!
I think he was attempting to
Just goofed the angle. You never usually go straight, or I could see how if he was attempting the hitbox where it literally sucks you in like a vacuum cleaner.
Yeah, it was either that.
He's a bit too far from that. On last stock, I can get the gamble, but like,
it's a spooky gamble.
It's hard. It's because if you mess it up that badly, that's what happens. Big Luma.
Nah, I was. We're not going onto a Pokemon stage.
I just need my camera.
You work on the camera, big dog. Got it.
Can we change these lights? Come on.
I think we can. I think we're allowed to. I think they're AON blue right now.
It's not working.
Oh, well. Anyway.
Is it on?
Oh, my man, no.
Nomeo.
So, we got game three.
Game three on Smashville. This is a best of five, I believe. Right? Top three AON is best of five?
Yes.
Yeah. Okay.
Game three.
Sorry, I haven't been here in a while, ladies and gentlemen.
Yeah, because we're trying to go home madly. lots of fans.
Yeah, so, I mean, as soon as Ray's out, because I think Ralphie's out already by a proxy.
I think so. Maybe. I think he may have gotten the same place as
I love Ralphie. I hope so, though, so we can go home no time. That'd be cool.
Well, Ray is looking poised right now to at least be in loser's finals.
Yeah,
so.
No. Right? Ray's been looking pretty nice all day. I mean,
Ray is pretty much nice, period.
Stocktaker, though, is the man to beat today, as he is first seed. So. I think Ray's second seed, so this is...
Yeah.
No, this is...
Get off my stage.
All according to Kikaku, as the weeb say.
Nice. Ray's left chopper, super solid. Not really letting Stuck in an opportunity. Ops jump that time, does jump, and then does an immediate double.
Ow.
Ow. Thanks, Sage. Anyway.
Rest in peace, headphone users.
Back throw.
Wow, the auto reticle offstage. I always get so envious of Palus who do the special moves offstage.
It's the most non-committal edgeguard on the planet.
It's not.
Here you go, and then you're just back on stage and ready for ledge trap again. Going for that 2-frame again, has missed the past couple times. He does have to shift himself forward a little bit to catch that, so his face is
wow, these B reverses are really sick. I'm liking these B reverses a lot by Stocktaker. The B reverse is such a good way because the gun already comes out pretty early.
Yeah.
But
and it has a hitbox on it itself.
Any way to trick up your movement on your opponent to where it's unreactable is nice.
And Ray says, I don't care about your gun. Eat this shield. Invincible. Nair. Uno mas? Si, senor.
Uno mas? Si, senor.
All right. That's
these dash attacks are being... Like, this man has been so consistent with his dash attacks. Like, I don't think he's missed that many of them.
I mean, that's the thing with Stocktaker is that he kind of does dash dance, and then he's like, oh, are you going to jump? Once he reacts to not you doing a button after you jump. He reacts to you jumping, and then he dash attacks
exactly.
in. Because the commitment's really not there for what if you're in the air. Like, yeah, sure, you might be able to double jump and then back air, but, like, you better have good aerial just to catch that move. Nice.
Ooh, excellent job dropping through the platform, too. Dropping through the platform and doing an aerial is probably one of the safest things you can do. You really can't get punished because most aerials, your hurt box shrinks a little bit.
Ooh, Dare. That's
wow, that was a cute little strip.
I would have liked to have seen Dare, personally.
Only, I mean, he got the fair, right?
Landing fair Dare is
Yeah, true. Landing fair Dare is
I don't know if it would have killed, but send a message.
Yeah, definitely. If you're up, any additional mental warfare you can add on is
back air, no jump.
These retreating back airs, Ray really has to watch his jumps. I feel like
fantastic recovery, by the way.
Ray has kind of been letting Stuck lead the neutral a lot. He's also just been doing these nervous jumps right at the top two.
Goodbye. Get scooped. Oh, you're living.
Not dead. My man is not ready for the Ben and Jerry's just
okay,
yet.
Okay, counter on the way down. I like it.
No.
So
back throw.
Oh, you dumb.
Alright, this should still be a Stock if he plays his cards right, but that move is insane. He's not dead.
He's living. Absolutely good.
Yeah.
Alright, there it is.
See, these jumps have been kind of questionable from Ray this
set
so far.
Yeah, I think...
he's been jumping into a lot of Stocktaker's aerials. Stocktaker's has always just been hovering within the range. Like, he's been doing a great job of hovering into the range where he can punish, but he can't get punished.
Yeah, it's one of those things as Wolf, you're kind of afforded that liberty because you have such great aerial distance, such massive hitboxes.
Right.
You're like, okay, this is my space. Do not infringe
upon
my
space.
Because I'm jumping a lot.
Don't come into my house to play with my toys. My mom didn't let you in. Stay outside.
This is my water gun.
My
water gun.
He's trying to get these shield poke nares as well. I think Stocktaker knows just to shield and angle shield up. Could be good. But man's going to take it on the Nair train. Oh, this is a good continue.
All right, air dodge in. Solid by Stock. Not going to get hit off there.
53, though.
I like the counter pick of Talent City. A couple up smash Stocks those last couple games. Not going to be dying off the top on the stage until very, very late. So
it also gives Ray a bit more opportunity to catch Stocktaker's landings. I feel like with how fast Wolf is and with how great his aerial drift is, he's able to get land and not stay in disadvantage for too long. Dicks.
We call
that an oopsie in the business.
Yeah, that's a head bonk.
Bonk. I think his Palutena turns into a rubber ball sometimes and decides,
nice
I'm going to cross my arms and not grab the ledge.
Unfortunately, parries, while better against projectiles now, are still not super ideal.
Yeah. Back throw.
That's enough?
Yoink. Yeah, that's enough. That would have been enough, I think, without the pummel as well, but I think he just wanted to be safe.
And the Stocktaker accepted it. He's like, all right, you got me. Safe on block. Nice parry.
That was a great back. Yeah, spot dodge immediately after. I think one thing that people could be catching on, and I think we mentioned this.
Yeah, we were talking earlier.
We talked about this earlier in the hallway where the spot dodge punishing game has not been too developed yet. I feel like a lot of players who play characters like Wolf excel at, like, they'll just throw out spot dodge as a way to not get whiff punished.
The issue with spot dodge punishing is that in this game it's a lot more difficult.
It's harder.
Just,
I'm not
it's
saying
a lot
it's
more
easy.
Just,
to
just react and punish.
Yeah.
In Smash 4, you can react to a spot dodge punish it. In this game, you can't really do that because of the ability to swing out.
It'll be there and gone before you know it.
Right, that's the thing. So you almost have to read a spot dodge, click a slow move, and then hit them in the lag of the spot dodge. Right. The very like small amount of it. So yeah, again, it's almost like you have to make a read to hit a spot dodge a lot of the time. I think, you know, it's possible. You have slow moves as Wolf and as Palutena, or lingering moves at the very least, that are going to be able to hit that. So let's see, you know, maybe
no
some more mixing up with tilt set of block.
Interesting. I feel like with the amount of rage Palo had, it would have killed, or at least given him stage control. Forward throw is such a weird thing because you're forcing your opponent to play neutral again with you. And as Palo, you kind of want your opponent off stage, and he's going to catch a dash attack for that. Yeah, I don't know why he did that. Maybe a little misinput.
The fact that little kick just, like, murders you.
It's ridiculous, like, dude. Bah! Put Wolf on the varsity soccer team. My man will dribble that ball into the goal every time. And slide tackle at the same time. He's got that option coverage.
Definitely.
These retreating aerials by Stocktaker have been so good to set. He's always been playing Ray within the range where he can outspace him single time.
Like my hitboxes, while they may not be all that disjointed, some of them are. Speaking of disjointed.
The thing about Palu is that her only hitbox that really ranges like OD far is Fair. And Fair is a pretty minute hitbox, I'd say.
Yeah, but the thing is with Bear is obviously it's invincible like on the whole side of her, so like that move is like you really can't challenge.
But even
it at
that
all.
Was nerfed a little, no, from four.
Wow, I don't know that for a fact.
All aboard the train. That's what I've heard. The credit's a little worse. It's still great. Don't get me wrong.
Yeah. I honestly don't know, but
yeah, some nerd in the chat correct me.
Artisan, anyway. But yeah, so potential last stock here for Ray in the winner's bracket.
Stocktaker. You died!
Oh my
you
god! Died! He exploded!
You died!
Wolf is
BS. That was so...
Wolf is cheap. Wolf is hecka dumb. Hecka dumb.
Put this man into game 7. This man was on his game 7 shit just now.
Ah! You died!
Dunked, dude.
You died!
That's my favorite. When you die off the bounce from the ground, it's so weak. It's so weak, bro.
It looks awful.
That shit's so funny.
It looks terrible.
You can't tech that.
You can't tech that in this game.
Nope.
They took that out.
Not off of that.
Not off of any spike.
Really? Any spike at all, you can't tech it?
I'm
pretty sure you can't some
it,
of them.
I forget if it's if you're standing, you can't.
If you're standing, I think you can't.
Alright.
He was standing. Oh, no, yeah. I don't think off Wolf of side B, though, at that percent. I think it might have been
Let us know how wrong we are in the chat.
Tell me how wrong I am. Dre, if you're here, tell me you're wrong.
Yeah,
tell me
how
why
how
I'm wrong,
wrong
also, so I
know,
don't say
I know
it
there
again.
Is something very different about teching the stage in this game, where I'm not sure if you could tech certain spikes against the stage. I know Ganon has never been able to do that
right.
with his dare.